Hi everyone, today we are going to learn how we create this spiral staircase in Rhino. And if you like this tutorial, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And if you have any projects that you want help on a one-to-one basis, just go to my website and book an appointment, or I'll share the link to the appointment in this description. Just have a look. So first of all, we will go into top view and create a circle, which is going to be from a point, and then a circle which is the diameter that we want. So right now we are going to do 1200, and then we will create line starting from this center. Okay, and then we are going to offset the line 150 on both sides, and then enter. Okay, now we are going to create this step using a loft command, loft and enter. Okay, now what we'll do next is to create this as a block. Okay, so this will be one block. Okay, we will edit it later, so we'll make this as a block first. Okay, with the center point, and we'll make this as step one, and then we have to use the array. So we'll select this one and we say array polar, and then we give the center point of the rotation, we give the number of items, then the rotation angle will be to 70 degrees, and we have to give, by default it will be z offset as 0, but we will give it as 190 millimeters. Okay, so we get this height, so each step is 190 millimeters away from each other, and then we press enter. So you get this spiral stair. Now it's still not done because we want to make sure it is. So what we are going to do is, now we are going to use the tween curve option. We're going to click on this edge, click this edge, enter, click on this edge and this edge, enter. Okay, or we'll just double click add object, select this object, select this, enter, set PP to flatten the geometry in the Z, and then we use the loft. Nice. And then we will add object again, add the bottom, and then we'll trim the edge, delete this one and delete the lines, and we can give a thickness to it, let's say -50 mils, press enter, and we have got a step. Now if you want an extra nosing happening, so you can double click on this extrude surface, and if you are working on Rhino 8, you can use the push pull command. So this is extrude surface, let's give it, let's say 20 mils or 30 mils nosing, and we will extrude this one down, and a kickboard which is another 10 mils, and we'll union this together, merge all faces, and we say okay. And we have to make the railing, so railing we just have to use the helix, or if you want you can just use the simple curves, true point, and use the points, and this will be 900 mils, extrude 20 mils, offset 30 mils, offset and make it solid 30 mils, yeah, and we have to have a post, so we'll have a post, so we'll do an extrude curve like this, extrude surface, another 20 mils, an array, a longer curve, array, a longer curve, and we select the curve, and then we have to make sure orientation is stair like, and the number of steps is equal to the number of balusters, is as per your design. Okay, maybe you want 24 or 12. I think 13 to match up. No, I think 12. Okay. And then press enter. You get the staircase. And if you like this tutorial, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And if you have any projects that you want help on a one-to-one basis, just go to my website and book an appointment, or I'll share the link to the appointment in this description. Just have a look. Thank you so much.